Hello friends, our next topic is as per Solar's lifesaving appliances. The first and foremost is the Lifebuoys. So Lifebuoys, the requirement for Lifebuoys are as follows. The inner diameter should be not less than 400 mm. The outer diameter should not be more than 800 mm. It should be made of an inherently buoyant material. It should be capable to withstand a drop test from twice the height at which it is stored, or 30 meter, whichever is greater. And when immersed in water, the Lifebuoy should be capable of withstanding at least 14.5 kg of iron for 24 hours of immersion in fresh water. Then the requirement of Lifebuoy is also it should be present with a grab line. The grab line should have should be of a length of 4 times the outer circumference of the Lifebuoy, and the minimum diameter of which should be of 9.5 mm, not less than 9.5 mm. It should be present in 4 equal loops, equidistantly placed, as you can see over here. The minimum number of Lifebuoys required are as follows. Before moving to that, the minimum mass of the Lifebuoy which is required is 2.5 kilograms. It should not be less than 2.5 kilograms. That is a requirement. Then as per the length for cargo vessels, as per the length, the minimum number of required Lifebuoys to be present on board are as follows. The length, if it is less than 100 meters, the minimum number of Lifebuoys to be present on board are 8. If the length is 100 meter to 150 meter, the number of Lifebuoys to be present is 10. If the length is 150 meter to 200 meters, the minimum requirement is of 12 Lifebuoys. If the length is 200 meter and above, the minimum requirement is of 14 Lifebuoys. I'm sorry. Now, 50% of these Lifebuoys should be fitted with self-igniting lights. Self-igniting lights should be of white in color. The luminous intensity of which should be of 2 candelas, and it should continuously burn for 2 minutes. Sorry, 2 minutes, I'm saying it's 2 hours. And at least 2, and it should be 50, and the Lifebuoys present on board should be equally placed on both the sides, your port side and starboard side. And at least one of the Lifebuoys should be present in the vicinity of the stern. And what are the next point? At least 2 of these Lifebuoys should be present with buoyant lines. The length of which should be at least twice the distance from the waterline to the distance it is stored at, or 30 meter, whichever is greater. And the buoyant lifeline should be non-kinking. It should the minimum diameter of it should be of 8 mm, and its breaking strength should be of 5 kilonewtons. Now, at least 2 of these Lifebuoys should be present with smoke signals for man overboard Lifebuoys. We'll get to it. Lifebuoys should be flame resistant. When enveloped in a flame, it should not burn or melt for at least 2 seconds. Then coming to man overboard Lifebuoys, at least 2 man overboard Lifebuoys should be present on the bridge wings, one at each side, with self-releasing with quick release mechanism. And these Lifebuoys, the mass of which should be not less than 4.5 kilogram, and it should be present with smoke signals. The smoke signal should burn for at least 15 minutes, and should burn for at least 10 seconds when immersed in water of 100 mm. And the self-igniting lights of man overboard Lifebuoys, the requirement is of 35 candela should be the luminous intensity. I'm sorry. And it should burn continuously for at least 45 minutes. Coming to markings on Lifebuoys are as follows. It should be of highly visible color. It should be fitted with retro reflective tapes. Ship's name and port of registry should be marked. That is all about Lifebuoys. We'll be moving on to our next topic. Thank you. Hello friends, so our next topic is regarding life jackets. Life jacket is another life saving appliance. Now, life jacket should be present for all the crew members, and additional in number should be present for watch officers, which are present on the navigation bridge and engine rooms, etc. And child life jackets. Child life jackets are total of 10% of the number of crew or the number of children, whichever is greater. Those mean number of child life jackets should be present on board. And a person of 140 kg of weight and who is having a chest girth of 1750 mm, for such a person, special arrangements have to be made in order to secure life jackets to such a person. Then coming to the buoyant material, life jacket should be made of a buoyant material, and the buoyancy should not reduce for more than 5% after 24 hours of immersion in fresh water. The life jacket should be of a fire resistant material. It should withstand, it should not melt or burn when enveloped in fire for 2 seconds, and it should be attached with a whistle along with a lanyard. Then it should have a self-igniting light, which should be white in color with a luminous intensity of 0.75 candela, and it should continuously burn for at least 8 hours. This the self-igniting light should present at least 50 flashes and not less than 70 flashes per minute. Then we have the release buoyant line. There should be a release, there is a requirement of a release buoyant line or some other means to attach a life jacket to another another person's life jacket in case of body warming and such instances. And there should be a mean, there should be means to allow a rescuer to lift the survivor from the water through that life jacket. And the life jacket should be capable of being worn only in one way, that is the right way. And a person with instructions and or without instructions should be capable of wearing the life jacket within 1 minute. Then the life jacket should be capable to withstand jumps from a height of 4.5 meter without causing any damage to the person or damage to the life jacket or dislodging of the life jacket. And then the life jacket should be capable to lift the mouth of any exhausted or unconscious person from water in not less than 5 seconds. And it should the requirement of it is as follows: that should be not less than 120 mm clear of water. The mouth should be 120 mm clear of water, with the body inclined backwards at an angle not less than 20 degree from the vertical position. So this is the requirement which the life jacket should fulfill. And coming to the markings on life jacket, the life jacket should be of a highly visible color. It should be having retro reflective tapes. It should be marked with the ship's name and port of registry. Also, the instructions on how to don a life jacket are present at times, along with diagrams. So this is all about your life jackets. Hello friends, so our next topic is immersion suits. Now immersion suits, this is another life-saving appliance. It should be present for each and every crew on board, including additional immersion suits should be present for officers on watch, including navigation bridge, your cargo control room, your engine room, etc. And this should be constructed of an approved waterproof material, and it should be fire resistant. It should not melt or burn when enveloped in fire for 2 seconds. And we should be able to unpack it and don it from the bag within 2 minutes along with life jacket. So usually we don the immersion suit first, and upon it we don the life jacket. That is how the immersion suits are donned. Or there are another type of immersion suits which come along with your inbuilt life jackets. And we'll come to that later. Then the immersion suit should cover the entire body except your face, and there should be an arrangement provided to reduce your free air in legs. That is a kind of air release valve is present for to reduce the free air in legs. And yeah, it should be able to, the another requirement regarding this is it should be able to withstand jumps from 4.5 meter of height, at least 4.5 meter of height, That is the requirement, and when you jump from that height, it should not cause dislodging or damaging to the suit, as well as no ingress of water should take place. Then you should be able to climb a ladder of at least 5 meters in length. You should be able to perform your abundant ship duties while wearing the immersion suit, and yeah, that is about it. And coming to these suits are present along with they are without insulations or with insulations. Now, if your immersion suit is without insulation, then the requirement is as follows. The body temperature should not fall more than 2 degrees on an immersion of 1 hour in calm circulating water of 5 degrees. So this is a requirement for immersion suits without insulation. And this, you have to don the immersion suit along with your warm clothing. First wear the warm clothing and then you can wear the immersion suit. Then coming to immersion suits with insulations. Now for this, the body temperature does not fall more than 2 degrees on an immersion of 6 hours in calm circulating water of 0 degree to 2 degrees Celsius. So this is another requirement. Now the exception. Exception is for the carriage of immersion suits may be granted only to cargo ships. So exception for only cargo ships constantly engaged in voyages in warm climate. Now voyages in warm climate means the area or the latitude between 30 degree north and 30 degree south. That is your voyages in warm climate. Now this does not apply to bulk carriers. Bulk carriers cannot be exempted. This is what is given in SOLAS. And coming to your buoyancy requirement. Buoyancy requirement is usually immersion suits are provided with a pillow, a kind of a pillow support, or your inbuilt life jackets. When it is provided with inbuilt life jackets, that time it should fulfill all the criteria of life jackets, all the requirement of life jackets, your whistle, your self-igniting lights, your the requirement of life jacket for inverting a person, uprighting a person, unconscious or exhausted person, clearing the mouth of a person 120 mm above the water, and bringing him up to a inclined position of vertical angle of 20 degree backwards. That is the requirement which should be fulfilled. And inverting a person within 5 seconds, uprighting a person within 5 seconds, clearing the mouth of a person from the water within 5 seconds, that is the requirement of buoyancy. And what else? Did we miss anything? Okay, and coming to markings and testing, I'll be explaining it in later. So coming to immersion suits markings. So markings on immersion suits, usually they are retroreflective tapes which are present, and the main markings are usually on the immersion suit bags, which give you the procedures and guidelines on the way to don the immersion suit, as well as diagrammatical instructions are also present. It presents manufacturer's name, date of manufacturing, date of testing. Coming to the testing of immersion suits, the pressure test. Now immersion suits should be pressure tested every 3 years. That is a requirement. Now this is usually done. We send the immersion suits to shore, or you have it. You have a pressure test kit on board. When you have a pressure test kit on board, this is the procedure. Now the air pressure which has to be which is required for a pressure test of immersion suit is 0.7 to 1.4 kilopascals. Now the procedure is as follows. When you have a pressure test kit on board, use that kit and attach it to the immersion suit as per the manufacturer instructions. Now once you inflate it with a pressure of 0.7 to 1.4 kilopascals, apply soap and look for bubbles. Wherever you find bubbles, now mark those areas, then wash it with fresh water, allow the suit to dry, and then repair the suit as per manufacturer instructions. So this is how you are going to do the pressure test and the maintenance of your immersion suits. Thank you. So friends, our next life-saving appliance is thermal protective aids. The thermal protective aid is nothing but it's a bag or a suit made of waterproof material with low thermal conductivity. Now this covers whole of your body except the face, and it presents maximal thermal conductance of, it should not be more than 7800 watt per meter square Kelvin. Your watt per meter square Kelvin is your heat transfer coefficient. So this is a requirement. Your maximum thermal conductance should not be greater than 7800 watt per meter square Kelvin. Now, it should be unpacked and donned easily without assistance. The carriage requirement of your thermal protective aid is as follows. It is carried in lifeboat, life raft, your rescue boat. It should be 10% in number, 10% of the crew or two, whichever is greater. Now, it should permit the wearer to remove it in water within 2 minutes. It shall function properly throughout the air temperature range of minus 30 degree to 20 degree. Now, the main function is it shall reduce convective and evaporative heat loss from wearer's body. So this is its main important function. Now, usually the question for TPA is asked like, what is the difference between TPA and immersion suits? So in immersion suits, you can swim, you can carry out your abandoned ship duties, you can climb a ladder. Whereas wearing a thermal TPA or your thermal protective aid, you cannot swim, you cannot perform abandoned ship duties, you cannot climb a ladder. So this is the difference between your immersion suits as well as thermal protective aid. So our next life-saving appliance are the pyrotechnics. So pyrotechnics, the requirement of pyrotechnics are as follows. There should be 12 rocket parachutes and 4 line-throwing appliances present on the navigation bridge. This is a requirement. Coming to the number of pyrotechnics required, those are 2, 4, 6 as we all know. 2 smoke signals, 4 hand flares and 6 rocket parachutes which have to be present on your lifeboat and life rafts, not on your rescue boat. Coming to, let's start up with hand flares. So hand flares, the validity of which is 3 to 5 years. Now 4 in number should be present on lifeboat as well as life raft. It should be contained in a water resistant casing with brief operating instructions as well as diagrammatical operating instructions should be present. So the casing should contain your manufacturer's name, trademark, your date of manufacturing, name of the testing authority and the date of testing. It should be present on the casing. Now the hand flare should contain self-contained means of ignition. And this should not cause any while using hand flares, it should not cause any discomfort to the person using it. Or it should not endanger the life raft or your lifeboat when you are using it. Now it should burn with a bright red color. The burning period should be not less than 1 minute. The average luminous intensity should be not less than 15,000 candela. That is a requirement. And continue to burn after having immersed in water for a period of 10 seconds under immersion of 100 mm of water. So this is a requirement for hand flares. So our next pyrotechnic is rocket parachutes. So rocket parachutes have a validity of 3 to 5 years. It depends on the manufacturer. Usually it is 3 years to 5 years. Now it should be present in a watertight casing with brief operating instructions, which should include your diagrammatical instructions which describe the procedures on how to use the rocket parachute. Now as we know, 12 in number should be present on the bridge and 4 in number to be present on the lifeboat as well as life raft. Coming to, should have an integral means of ignition, and the minimum vertical height of the parachute should reach 300 meters, that is minimum. The parachute should get activated on reaching the top of the trajectory or nearly the top of the trajectory. Should burn with a bright red flare, and the burning period should be not less than 40 seconds. Should have a minimum luminous intensity of 30,000 candela. Should have a minimum rate of descent, should be not less than 5 meters per second. Now arrangement should be made such that the flare should not damage the parachute or burn the parachute. So these are all the requirements of your rocket parachute. So our next topic is buoyant smoke signals. Buoyant smoke signals have a validity of 3 to 5 years. It depends on the manufacturer. Some have 3 years, some have 4, some have 5 years. Depends on the manufacturer. They are contained in water resistant casing with brief operating instructions and diagrammatical explanation of how to use the buoyant smoke signal. Now these are present 2 in number that we know. They are in the lifeboat and life raft. Now they should when operating with as per the manufacturer instruction, it should not ignite or explode, and on operational it should not emit flames. It should emit smoke of a highly visible color at a uniform rate. It should not emit any flame or explode. It should not be swammed in a seaway. Swam means the water should not get into it and cause it to drown or sink. So it should not get swamped in a seaway. And next point is, it should emit smoke for a minimum period of 3 minutes. That this is a requirement as per SOLAS. And it should continue to emit smoke when submerged in water for a period of 10 seconds under 100 mm of water. So this is all about boiled smoke signals. So our next topic is line throwing appliance, line throwing apparatus. So four in number should be present on the navigation bridge. That is four line throwing apparatus to be present on your navigation bridge. It should be contained in a water-resistant casing with integral means of ignition. That is for your in case of pistol-fired rockets, or in case of arrangements where a rocket along with line is present in the casing. In those cases, it should be present in a watertight resistant casing, and it must have a reasonably good accuracy. It should have brief operating instructions along with the diagram of how to operate the line throwing apparatus, and each projectile. There are four in number, four projectiles. Each projectile should be carrying a line of at least 230 meters in length in calm water. This is a requirement. And the breaking strength of each of these lines should be not less than 2 kN. That is another requirement. So these are all the requirements of line throwing apparatus.